whom do you trust on the economy? There's a new Washington Post ABC poll that shows the public trust in President Obama on the economy, well, it's nearly neck and neck with the GOP. And it gets worse for the president. His job approval rating is 50%. That's down 5 points just from January. Joining the company now, Democratic Congressman John Yarmuth from Kentucky. Congressman, it seems like perhaps this might start to persuade the president to move more to the middle. Do you think he's going to be more willing now to compromise?
Well, I think he's been willing to compromise. I mean, if you look at the deal made during the fiscal cliff, he started by asking for $1.4 trillion worth of new revenue. He ended up settling for $600 billion over 10 years. I mean, that's more than a 50% compromise just on that one item. He's talked about being sympathetic to change CPI on Social Security. I mean, I think there are a lot of ways
With all due respect, sir, I mean, compromise in a sense that the other side gets a little bit of what they want. No, the president didn't get all the money, but the ratio of $41 in tax hikes to $1 in spending cuts, that was a little lopsided.
Well, but that's on top of the $1.2 trillion that was already cut as part of the Budget Control Act in 2011. So we're at about 3-to-1 already in terms of cuts versus revenue, which is about the ratio that Simpson-Bowles recommended.
And that's the ratio that I think most Americans like. I mean, you guys know, I would suspect you probably understand that the American public isn't looking for a ratio more draconian than that.
Well, I think what the American people are looking for are people who are working together and appear to be working together in an organized, competent way to deal with our national challenges. And there's too much dysfunction. I think the whole, first the fiscal cliff and then the sequester debate has damaged that confidence, and it hurts the president and it hurts members of Congress as well.
The tour that the president went on for sequestration, city to city, bashing Republicans, it feels like that almost everyone says he overplayed his hand. That was an overreach and it's backfired. I'm hoping, to your point, we don't see those sort of gimmicks anymore, and that perhaps the dinners, the reaching across the aisle, that will happen. Should we be more hopeful that some sort of compromise or even a grand bargain could be struck?
You know, I think there's reason to hope. Get a sense from the new members of Congress, both Republicans and Democrats, that they come with a lot less ideological baggage than maybe the last few classes of members of the House have come with. They seem more pragmatic and prone to wanting to get something done. I'm working as part of an immigration group that's making great progress on a bipartisan way and addressing that challenge. So I think there's some reason that for hope that we can work together.
Let's just say it doesn't happen. You know, even though, and I got to tell you, everyone's feeling better about perhaps this happening. Let's say it doesn't happen. Will we go back to the demonization and the finger pointing, or will we use this as a launching pad to just try harder, better the next time around?
Yeah, I think both sides are pretty much finished with the demonization. We're all engaged to a certain extent in political theater, and we all go back to our districts, and we've got our bases that we need to feed red meat to. That's part of the crazy world we live in. But I think the mentality is different now, and I think there's a much greater realization that even from our base supporters, we're hearing, you know, we're tired of the finger pointing, just get something done, and everybody's hearing that now, so I think it's having its effect.
Amen. Congressman Yarmuth, thanks a lot. We appreciate your time this morning.
All right, Charles.